quick video while I'm getting ready for bed. I haven't been around here lately because I took this weekend off from doing anything that anyone expected me to do or wanted me to do, including myself. Like, I didn't really force myself to do anything. I did kind of, pressure myself into doing, like, cleaning and stuff. But I got a lot of stuff clean. Did laundry today. I made tons. Like, not really tons, but I spent most of the time working on road art, which is, I don't know, I'm sure some people would see it as a waste of time, but it really isn't. It really makes me happy. It makes me feel good. It's a good thing. It's a fun way to share stuff with the world. And it's good for me to do. I told my friend, like, there's, you know, my friend that I go spend weekends over at his house occasionally, I told him I wasn't gonna come out this weekend because I was just doing some taking care of myself, you know, because I spend a lot of time trying to take care of other people. I mean, I don't know, it's, like, maybe not, you know, it's not like I have little kids or anything. My kids are grown up, but not totally grown up, but they're big enough where they don't need me wiping their butts and stuff. So, and I do get to do a lot of stuff for myself, but I guess I just don't. Like, a lot of times I run around like a chicken with my head cut off, and I do a lot of nothing. I do a lot of stuff, but I don't accomplish anything, and I spend the whole time stressed out and thinking that I should be doing something that I'm not doing, or vice versa. And so it was nice this weekend to just kind of give myself permission to just relax and just do things that nurture myself, do things that take care of myself, like my art, like, you know, I don't know, I wrote a whole book. Hold on a second, I'll pause this thing and I'll show you. Okay, this is the book. Like, I wrote an illustrated whole book this weekend. It's a book for a worm, but it's a bookworm, and it goes something like, I don't know, I don't want to take the book out of there to read it, but it's a little poem about a bookworm. It's like, Bob the bookworm loved to read, but hands were the thing he needed until he found this neck book stand. Now he can hold it with no hand. That's the book. So anyway, that's Bob. This is one of the road art things. That's what I call it. I find stuff on the road and then I duct tape it and put eyes on it. Usually googly eyes. These were just eyes from some other kind of, like, McDonald's toy or something. But anyway. So that's like, oh, the plan is to take it to the library and give it to them, because usually I zip tie stuff and put it out on the road. So cute! Okay, usually I just zip tie it to places around, to fences and stuff, but this one, I think it'll get ruined too quick, and since it's got a little book, but I gotta get some packaging tape and then laminate the pages of the book so that it's a little bit more durable. Actually, I might rewrite the whole thing, tape it up or something. My handwriting sucks because, you know, my fingers shake and all that. But anyway, okay, so this weekend, did a lot of nothing, like, Not really. I mean, it was productive nothing because I did so much art and I did write. I worked a little bit on my play and I wrote no, I don't think I did any other writing. But I did work a little bit on the play. And then let's see, tomorrow is my go out day. I haven't gone out all weekend. I've just stayed home all weekend, and it's really been good for me because a lot of times I'll start getting ready to go to my friend's house. I usually leave to go there Thursday night and then stay through Sunday or Monday, and or if my kids come over, then you know they're here and I just hang out with my kids and stuff. But like I don't know what the difference was, but it was really good. I think I'm just one of those people who just needs alone time sometimes. Like, okay, when I was a kid, then I went to a little private church school and we had maybe 26 kids in the whole school, I think, at the biggest time. And so you know, like, I was the only kid in my grade for a year or two, and I grew up in the country, and I just like having alone time. I always have. I undoubtedly always will. But it felt really good this weekend. I'm glad I got it, and put in the headband on, because I'm gonna put this lotion is absolutely awesome, like, so awesome that I should pause and give it a moment of silence, but I won't even do that, because I'm just going to put it on my face. But it's awesome. All you get to see. Back it up. Rewind. Okay, so, anyway, I was going to do Mihen Day and all that stuff. Maybe I'll do it tomorrow for Mihen Day Monday. But I need to, I want to watch, the Cheap Thrills video for one, because, that one has such good movement stuff. Stretches and range of motion stuff, and but you know, so does Bruno Mars. It is a lot of my favorite music video people. Gets thirsty for this lotion. Like, seriously, if I haven't used it in a while, then I will miss it. My skin will just crave. My hands too. But it's called Skin Repair Cream. But it smells really good. It feels really good. It works great. I think it helps my wrinkles. Time will tell. Or time won't tell, because time hurts my wrinkles. But either way, it'll work. So anyway, I haven't even been making YouTube videos this weekend because, like, I don't know. I need to just, I don't know, refresh myself. And I think that's why I'm tonight, because maybe I am feeling refreshed enough. I feel like I am starting to have something to give back. My neighbor I got to hang out with her tonight. She's really sweet. We are kindred spirits. When I was over there, she said, do you ever get that feeling of, like, deja vu? Like, we've been here before. And I was like, yeah. It's cool, but, yeah, it is. It does feel really familiar. It felt really familiar in her house. Just felt like I had been there before. It felt like it was meant to be, like, and so I said something like, maybe in another life. Great. Maybe in another life. But yeah, you never know. But, anyway, I think that we are meant to be friends, and I'm glad I was able to go hang out with her. I don't usually do a lot of socializing, but I'm glad, you know, fate, karma, God, whatever you choose to believe it, the forces that be pushed me to call her and to go over there, and I'm glad they did, and I'm glad I listened. I've been trying to listen to my intuition a lot lately, and also to just be, of course, watched TED Talks and, you know, listened to stuff about just living in the moment and stuff, which, of course, I agree with, and I try to live my life like that, and I think usually I do, but it really helps when you listen to your heart, your intuition, your guts, the forces that are outside, whatever it is. There's something that will tell you where to go and tell you what to do if you just listen. And so I feel like I have been listening, but then part of me also second guesses everything and judges myself, and I think, no, you should be doing this, you should be doing that. But then I also am trying to recognize that there is a lot of power and there is a lot of good, like, results that come from just being, just breathing, just realizing that you are here where you are, and life is important, and life is beautiful, and life is special, and each moment is valuable. And so, anyway, that's what I've been trying to just, like, reflect on. But now that I've washed my face and done my zits up and put my lotion on, now I'm going to take my meds, and then I'm going to actually watch, like, some kind of show. And I know that that is very unproductive, and it's not, anyway, I'm not going to, like, my mind will tell me all this stuff. My mind will say, ooh, that's not embracing yourself, that's not encouraging your creativity, that's also not helping someone else, that's also not doing anything productive, anything important, that's not making you money, that's not cleaning your house, that's not doing anything, that's not, you know, taking a shower, whatever. My brain tries to explain all the reasons why I should be doing something other than what I choose to do. But I'm trying to find the balance, because there is a balance, because sometimes, you know, you aren't doing the things that you know deep down inside you really want to do, like with my book and stuff. I really do want to write, and I say that a lot, but then I don't take the steps that are going to get me there instead of in one of the TED Talks I was watching. But it was like, you know, you have to tell yourself why you do want to do something to make your brain, you know, your brain listens to what you say. And so if you say, oh man, this sucks, I gotta do this, then your brain is going to think, oh yeah, it sucks, we don't want to do this. But if you say positive things to yourself, you explain, oh, this is something I really want to do. I really want to write my book. I really want to finish the play. I really want to work on my children's book. I have a lot of writing that I really want to do, and so I'm going to do it because that's something that feeds me and it will help someone else, you know, and it's good for me, and so I'm going to do it. But tonight, I'm going to just watch a show just to relax and to zone out, to not think of anything, and to just get my mind ready for bed, because tomorrow is my day to go out. I gotta go to city council, I gotta go do all that stuff. And so, today's my day, tonight's my last night to just be, and just relax, and, so sometimes just chilling out with a good show is a good way to do that. So, I'm gonna get off here.